Hey y'all, my name's Tyson, and let's talk about built-in, real-time, one checkbox, ambient occlusion. So if you already know what ambient occlusion is, you should be very excited. And if you don't know what ambient occlusion is, we're gonna show you. And you should be very excited. It is a brand new to this 2024 release style attribute that will give you some incredible depth, an incredible kind of built-in real-time rendering capabilities. It's super cool, nothing like actually showing it off. So let's jump in. So this is a typical what we might expect from SketchUp, right? And we can turn shadows on and etc., etc. Let's open up styles and just edit whatever we've got going on here. Now under styles, we have the typical edges, but now under faces, there is this checkbox. And if we click this, ambient occlusion, all of a sudden you can see that what it does is it gives sort of the space between surfaces a sort of a shading. Let's look at this. In a different way, right? I'm orbiting around. Ambient occlusion is still on. Hey, so fun. Let me draw a simple. Let's just say draw a box. And as I draw this, you can see that all of the corners here have this kind of shading to them. And all this is two sliders that we have options to control this. The distance, so you can see how sort of the distance in those corners grows. And if you push this all the way, you get more of just kind of a general surface shading. And the intensity, which of course just turns up how deep or how dark to make that ambient occlusion shading. And as you saw, like I say, this is real time. And it's that easy. There's not much more to say other than how amazing is this. So let me grab this, let me just get rid of it, and let's have a look at a few of the default styles that are built in with ambient occlusion, and then maybe we'll play around and create one or two of our own. So if we come up to select, now there is an ambient occlusion section here under styles, and let's just have a look at a few of these. This is sort of, I don't know what to call it. Obviously, a kind of golden toned, little sketchy style. So you can just jump into some of these and tweak your way through them. Or like I say, you can easily add it to any existing style. So if we just, let's just jump over here to default styles. And let's say we take this one, but let's turn it, to hidden. So we have no texture showing, and let's edit it. In fact, what would happen if we turned edges off entirely, right? Nothing's going on, but let's turn on ambient occlusion and we get this kind of lovely shading and a lot of depth in the model. So maybe let's take this and combine it with, let's do add edges, let's add profile edges, but just with attribute of one, and maybe make these profile edges more of a light gray so that they're not standing out, but just a little bit of edges. What a, like, How fun is that? And then just keep going from there. Do we want shading? Do we want textures? Do we want to have a little more of the ambient occlusion effect here? So you get the idea. It's just something that's going to interact with any of the models you create. Like say it's sort of just the shading that's going to happen between surfaces coming together. Go out there and try it. That's really all there is to it. It's just so cool. I'm very excited to see new and beautiful images coming out of your SketchUp models. This is going to be fun. And I don't know. That's I want to show more, but that's as much as there is. It's just that easy and that amazing. Yeah, so like I say, really quick to show, part of the new SketchUp 2024. Give it a try. Share with us some of your most beautiful images. And I want to give a quick shout out to our dev team. A feature like this, sometimes it feels like it's unique to just like, oh, they've just been building this for the past couple months. But in fact, especially this sort of thing where it's underlying rendering engine performance, this has probably been in development for multiple release cycles, and you've seen some aspects of performance and, you know, ability and just speed, other things, but it's finally enabled the team to create this beautiful new rendering option that's just built in. And so huge shout out to the dev team for this amazing new feature and all the work that goes into every one of these releases. There's a lot more under the hood, if you will, than often we see. And I'm excited about this one. So thank you all. Let us know what you think. Let us, like I say, please jump into the forums and share some of the images you create with this new ambient occlusion style. Thanks, y'all. We'll see you the next time.